There's a room beneath the border of Switzerland and France, where the world's most precise instruments are watching something that shouldn't be there. It's not loud. It's not dramatic. It's a whisper, a deviation so small it would fit inside the width of a human hair a billion times over. But it's consistent. And in physics, consistency is everything. At CERN, home to the Large Hadron Collider, scientists have spent decades confirming what we know about reality. They've found the Higgs boson. They've recreated the conditions of the Big Bang. They've proven again and again that the standard model of particle physics, our best map of the universe, is correct. But now, that map has a crack in it. And no matter how many times they check, no matter how many experiments they run, the crack remains. What happens when the universe starts breaking its own rules? What happens when precision becomes a problem? Today, we're going deep into one of the most important mysteries in modern science. A mystery hiding in plain sight, written in the language of particles so small we can barely imagine them. A mystery that could rewrite everything. This is the story of Kern's anomaly, the one that won't go away. Kern is not just a laboratory, it's a cathedral of human curiosity. A 27-kilometer ring buried up to 175 meters beneath the Earth, where protons are accelerated to 99.999991%, the speed of light, and smashed together 11,000 times per second. The goal? To see what reality is made of. Inside this machine, temperatures drop colder than deep space. Magnetic fields stronger than anything found in nature bend particles into perfect circles. Detectors, the size of apartment buildings, capture the fragments of collisions that last less than a trillionth of a second. And from all that chaos, we've built something extraordinary, the standard model. Think of the standard model as the periodic table of everything. It describes 17 fundamental particles, the building blocks of matter, and the forces that hold them together. Electrons, quarks, photons, neutrinos. It explains why atoms stick together, why light exists, why the sun burns. It's been tested millions of times, and it works. When scientists predicted the existence of the Higgs boson in the 1960s, it took 50 years to find it. But when they did, its properties matched the standard model's predictions almost perfectly. That's the power of this framework. It doesn't guess, it calculates. But here's the thing about perfect maps. They only work if the territory doesn't change. And recently, the territory has started to shift. It began quietly, the way most revolutions do. Around 2015, physicists at CERN's LHCb experiment, one of several massive detectors along the collider ring, started noticing something unusual in how certain particles decayed. They were studying something called bimesons, unstable particles made of quarks that exist for only a fraction of a second before breaking apart. According to the standard model, when a bimeson decays, it should produce electrons and muons, two types of leptons, at roughly the same rate. Electrons and muons are like cousins. They have the same charge, the same behavior, just different masses. The standard model treats them almost identically, so their production rates should match. But they didn't. The data showed that bimesons were decaying into electrons more often than muons, not by much, only about 15% more than expected, but in particle physics, 15% might as well be a chasm. At first, the team was cautious. Anomalies appear all the time in experimental physics. Detector glitches, statistical flukes, calibration errors. Most of them vanish when you gather more data. So they gathered more data. 2016, still there. 2017, still there. 2018, the anomaly sharpened. By 2021, after years of cross-checking, recalibrating, and reanalyzing, the LHCb collaboration made a careful announcement. The deviation had reached a statistical significance of 3.1 sigma. In physics, 3 sigma means there's about a 1 in a 1,000 chance the result is a fluke. It's not proof, but it's no longer ignorable. And then, other experiments started seeing it too. Science is a conversation. One lab makes a claim. Others test it. If the claim holds, it becomes knowledge. If it doesn't, it fades. But this anomaly didn't fade. At Fermilab, near Chicago, scientists were conducting their own experiment called Muon G-2, a completely different setup studying the magnetic properties of muons. In 2021, they published results showing that muons were behaving slightly differently than the standard model predicted. The discrepancy? About 4.2 sigma. Strong enough that physicists around the world started paying very close attention. Then came the Bell 2 experiment in Japan, re-examining similar B-meson decays. Their data hinted at the same pattern CERN had found. Different experiments, different countries, different particles, same problem. Dr. Mitesh Patel, a physicist at Imperial College London, working on the LHCb experiment, put it this way in a 2022 interview. We've checked everything. The detectors, the software, the theoretical calculations. We've run the numbers forwards and backwards, and the anomaly remains. At some point, you have to start asking, what if this isn't an error? What if this is real? What if the universe is trying to tell us something? Here's the uncomfortable truth. The standard model is incomplete. We've known this for a long time. It doesn't explain gravity. It doesn't explain dark matter, the invisible substance that makes up 27% of the universe. It doesn't explain dark energy, the force pushing galaxies apart. The standard model describes about 5% of everything that exists. The rest? Mystery. But until now, within its own domain, the world of particles and forces we can see, it's been flawless. These anomalies at CERN and Fermilab are different. They're not about what's missing. They're about what's wrong, or at least incomplete, in the very heart of the model. If muons and electrons really do behave differently in B-meson decays, it means something is breaking what physicists call lepton universality, the idea that all leptons are treated equally by the forces of nature. And if something is breaking that rule, it could only be one thing, a new force, a new particle, something we've never seen before. Theoretical physicist Dr. Ben Alanak from Cambridge University has spent years modeling what this could be. In interviews, he's described hypothetical particles called leptoquarks, hybrids that could bridge quarks and leptons in ways the standard model doesn't allow. Others propose new types of Higgs bosons, or particles tied to dark matter, leaking into our visible world. But here's the beauty and the frustration of physics. It's not enough to imagine. You have to measure, you have to prove, and proving something this subtle requires the most precise experiments ever designed. Particle physics is a game of shadows. You can't see a quark, you can't hold a muon, you can only watch what they leave behind. Trails of energy, tiny flashes of light, statistical patterns in oceans of data. And to see those shadows clearly, you need the best eyes humanity can build. CERN's LHCb detector is one of those eyes. It's designed specifically to study the subtle differences in particle behavior, the kind of differences that could reveal new physics. Since the anomaly was first detected, the LHCb team has upgraded the detector, improved its software, and collected datasets 10 times larger than before. In 2022, they published an updated analysis. The anomaly was still there. In fact, it had grown slightly more significant. But significance isn't certainty. In particle physics, the gold standard is 5 sigma, a 1 in 3.5 million chance of being a fluke. That's the threshold where a discovery becomes official. The CERN anomalies are hovering between 3 and 4 sigma. Close, but not there yet. So the question is, do we have enough data to call this real? Or are we staring at the most elaborate coincidence in scientific history? Dr. Sheldon Stone, a physicist at Syracuse University involved in LHCb, said this in a recent seminar. Every time we add more data, I expect the anomaly to go away. And every time, it doesn't. That's when you start to feel it. That tingle. The sense that you might be standing on the edge of something new. That tingle has a name. It's called discovery. But it's fragile. History is full of anomalies that vanished under scrutiny. In 2011, scientists thought they'd found particles moving faster than light. They hadn't. It was a loose cable. So CERN is being careful. Methodical. They're not declaring victory. They're just watching. Watching as the same result appears, again and again, like a ghost that refuses to leave. Let's imagine, just for a moment, that this is real. Let's say that in 5 years, with more data, CERN confirms beyond doubt that the standard model is wrong, that there is a new force, a new particle, something fundamental we've been missing, what would that mean? First, it would mean our map of reality needs an update, not a small correction, a whole new territory. If lepton universality is broken, if muons and electrons don't play by the same rules, then the forces governing the subatomic world are richer and stranger than we thought. It could point toward the physics of dark matter. Many theoretical models that explain the Kern anomalies also predict particles that could make up the invisible mass holding galaxies together. It could explain why the universe has more matter than antimatter. The standard model can't account for that imbalance, but new particles interacting in asymmetric ways might. And in the long term, decades, maybe centuries from now, understanding these new forces could unlock technologies we can't yet imagine. Think about it. 100 years ago, we were just discovering the electron. 50 years later, we had transistors, computers, the internet, quantum mechanics, once an abstract curiosity, now powers the device in your pocket. The particles Kern is hunting today could be the foundation of the technologies our grandchildren build. But there's another possibility, one that's quieter, but just as profound. What if this anomaly teaches us that the universe is more delicate than we realized? That the rules we think are absolute are actually approximate, good enough for everyday life, but not quite right at the edges? It's a humbling thought. For all our equations and experiments, we're still learning the grammar of existence. And every anomaly, every deviation, every stubborn little crack in the data is the universe correcting our pronunciation. Behind every data point, there's a person. The Kern anomaly didn't appear on a screen one day like a revelation. It emerged slowly, from the work of thousands of physicists, engineers, and technicians, people who spend years, sometimes entire careers, chasing signals that might mean nothing. They write code to filter billions of events. They calibrate magnets to the width of an atom. They sit in conference rooms arguing over statistical methods and systematic uncertainties. Dr. Yasmin Amis, a physicist on the LHCb team, described it this way in a 2023 interview. People think discovery is this sudden moment, a eureka, a flash of light. But it's not. It's gradual. It's checking the same plot 100 times and noticing it hasn't changed. It's the slow realization that maybe, just maybe, nature is whispering something new. And there's a strange kind of courage in that patience. In a world that demands quick answers and instant results, these scientists are willing to sit with uncertainty. To say we don't know yet, but we're looking. There's something deeply human in that, the willingness to admit ignorance, the drive to reduce it, one measurement at a time. And it reminds us that science isn't a finished product, it's a process. A conversation between humanity and the cosmos, carried out in laboratories and on chalkboards, in peer-reviewed journals, and late-night arguments over coffee. The CERN anomaly is part of that conversation, a question mark written in the language of particles. And we don't know the answer yet, but we're listening. So where do we go from here? CERN isn't stopping. The LHCb detector is currently undergoing a major upgrade, designed to collect data at 5 times its previous rate. When it comes back online, it will have the sensitivity to either confirm the anomaly beyond any doubt, or watch it dissolve into statistical noise. At the same time, Fermilab's Muon G-2 experiment is continuing its measurements, refining the precision of its results with every run. And at Bell 2 in Japan, researchers are gathering data that could provide independent confirmation, or challenge, CERN's findings entirely. This is science at its best, competitive, collaborative, relentlessly skeptical. Different teams, different approaches, all aimed at the same question. Is this real? By the mid-2020s, we should have an answer. Either the anomaly will cross the 5 sigma threshold and become a confirmed discovery, the first crack in the standard model, or it will fade, another ghost in the machine, a reminder that nature is subtle and our tools are still learning to see. But here's what strikes me most about this story. Even if the anomaly turns out to be nothing, even if it's a fluke, a miscalculation, a peculiarity of the detector, the search itself matters. Because every time we ask a question about the universe, we become a little more conscious. Every time we measure something with greater precision, we sharpen our understanding of what real even means. In the anomalies, the mysteries that don't fit, the data that doesn't behave, those are the places where new knowledge grows. Isaac Asimov once said, "The most exciting phrase to hear in science, the one that heralds new discoveries, is not Eureka, but that's funny. Kern's anomaly is that's funny. And humanity's leaning in. Step back for a moment. Zoom out. We're standing on a small planet, orbiting an average star, in the suburbs of a galaxy containing 400 billion others just like it. We are, by cosmic standards, impossibly tiny. And yet we've built machines that can see the structure of space-time. We've split atoms. We've photographed black holes. We've written equations that predict the behavior of particles smaller than we can ever touch. We've taken the chaos of existence and found patterns in it. That's what the Standard Model is. A pattern. A song we learned to hear in the noise, and for 50 years it's been beautiful. But songs can have hidden verses. And the CERN anomaly might be the first note of a new one. What if this small deviation, this 15% difference in decay rates, this whisper in the data, is the thread that, when pulled, unravels a whole new layer of reality? What if dark matter isn't some distant abstract thing, but something woven into the very particles we're studying right now? What if the forces we know, electromagnetism, the strong and weak nuclear forces, are just the visible surface of something deeper, something vast, something we've only begun to glimpse? Or what if the universe is exactly as strange as it seems? A place where the rules bend, where certainty is provisional, where every answer gives birth to 10 new questions. Either way, we win. Either we discover something new and expand the boundaries of knowledge, or we confirm what we already know with even greater confidence. Either way, we learn. And that's the gift of anomalies like this one. They remind us that the universe is not obligated to make sense to us. It doesn't owe us clarity. It just is. And we, curious, stubborn, imperfect, are trying to understand it anyway. The CERN anomaly is still there. Measured. Rechecked. Persistent. It hasn't been explained away. It hasn't vanished. It's sitting in the data like a riddle, waiting for us to solve it. Or prove it was never really there. And somewhere beneath the French-Swiss border, in tunnels so precise they account for the tides of the moon, scientists are still looking. They're accelerating particles. They're counting decays. They're comparing measurements to predictions, line by line, event by event. They're asking the universe a question, and they're waiting, patiently, for it to answer. Maybe the answer will rewrite physics, maybe it won't. But the question, the wondering, the searching, the refusal to accept mystery as final, that's what makes us human. The universe is vast, it's old, it's strange beyond measure, and we're just getting started. If discoveries like this fascinate you, subscribe, because the cosmos has more secrets than we have time to count.